Hi on, I have a pencil in my hand. See, it contains lead through which we write in our books. So this is nothing but graphite. It is made up of carbon atoms. Carbon is an element. Okay, so this carbon forms a hexagonal structure in the graphite. And one above the other, these hexagonal sheets are placed. With weak forces, they are attached. So this is graphite chemically. How this graphite turns into diamond? See, our earth contains three layers, just like a boiled egg. If you see, three layers you can see, yellow, white and the outer shell. Same way, the earth contains crust, mantle and core. So in the mantle, these diamonds are formed. How they are formed? They are formed at high temperatures and pressure. So how they come out? When the volcanoes erupt through the magma, they come out as diamonds and found in some mines. So next thing is, what is the relationship between this graphite and diamond? How at high temperatures and pressure this graphite is converted into diamond? Even diamond is made up of carbon, but it's in the form of cubes. One cube is placed above the other, and unlike graphite, they form very strong covalent bonds. Strong bonds with each other. So graphite and diamond are chemically both made up of carbon only. That is the reason at high temperature and pressure graphite can be converted into diamond, and it is given a name, allotropes of carbon. Allotropes of carbon examples are graphite and diamond. Why are we calling it as allotrope? Because they are chemically containing carbon, but physically they are different. So today, by just looking at the pencil, you have learned about allotropes of carbon, graphite and diamond. Thank you.